Good morning, everybody. 3 years ago, experts noted that as we embark on the fourth industrial revolution, it is clear that technology will play a central role in almost every aspect of our life. But this year, faced us with new problems, with new increasing role of information communication technologies because of unexpected, unplanned transferring to remote work and remote education. And they accompanied with the new period requirements and needs for transfer and reformation of ICT. And to some extent, we can speak about ICT evolution. We propose to discuss questions around three problems or group problems: ICT evolution up to today's necessity to involve much more resources in a synthetic environment and modeling. The group question related to modeling and simulation as a service and simulation as a tool. Because the Davos World Economic Forum in January of this year raised the question of the school of the future, what it would be, in particular, the need to identify new models of education for the fourth industrial revolution with respect to the situation on the IT market of workforce, because more and more specialties, more and more occupations appeared extremely, even every month. Our purpose of this presentation and our work was to develop the model of the ICT transformation from shared access computers to e-learning tools and technologies, especially with respect to synthetic environment and opportunities to use modeling and simulation in education and science and other aspects of work. The model of transformation of the digital education can be presented as evolutional stages with corresponding types of digital tools and directions of support for the education process. If the first stage can be described as one shared access computer for many users working offline, the next one had a new feature, possibility for a user to work online. The next stage of ICT evolution dealt with personal computers that became later smaller and more mobile. Networks provided users with extended possibilities, limited from point of view and access to different resources. Their development was a transformation into cloud-based resources friendly and extended for users' needs. The last stage that we live on can be characterized as much more flexible and person-oriented. The appropriate tools provide a user with opportunity to live and to act in the synthetic environment, virtual, augmented, mixed, etc., and provide opportunity for adaptive learning and construction of the personal trajectory of learning. Learning is transforming from obtaining a set of facts or prescribed knowledge into the search of knowledge needed for the learner and the synthesis of such knowledge by the learner himself using a wide spectrum of tools. Because the amount of facts and knowledge becomes crucial every day, the search as such became not enough. Modeling and simulation give new opportunity to explore the world for people. In recent years, the use of cloud-based modeling and technology and service-oriented architecture has been increasingly widespread in the world, offering greater use of modeling and simulation capabilities to meet critical societal needs. Modeling and simulation is the use of models as a basis for simulating to analyze data used to make managerial or technical decisions. It was earlier in previous years, but over last decade, modeling and simulation as a service appeared as a new concept that includes a focus on servicing and delivering modeling and simulating applications through a cloud computing model as a service to provide more simulation environments that can be deployed and executed at the user's request. The MSaaS paradigm supports offline use as well as the integration of multiple simulated and real systems into a single cloud simulation environment when needed. The general architecture of the learning process with modeling and simulation as a service can be represented as an administration of the modeling and simulation cloud, exchanging by metadata with customers of the education institution. Repository of the administration site contains all available modeling areas that can be specified and adjusted to the needs of the particular education institution and or subject area. From in this light, the education community framework for modeling and simulation as a service enables the community of users to discover new opportunities for users to enhance their operational performance and optimizing efforts in the process. For modeling and simulation aims to provide the user with discoverable services that are readily available on demand and deliver a choice of application. The modeling and simulation as a service concept is illustrated in this picture. MSaaS is an enterprise-level approach for discovery, composition, execution, and management of modeling and simulation services. It provides a linking element between modeling and simulation services. What is especially interesting and important in this model that we developed? Application to the education community framework for modeling and simulation as a service defines user-facing capabilities front end and underlying technical infrastructure back end with development and adaptation to the specific type of activity. The front end can be called the EDU MSaaS portal. It provides access to a large variety of modeling and simulation capabilities from which the users are able to select the services that best suit their requirements. The users can discover, learn, compose, and execute model and simulating services through the front end, which is the central access point that guides them through the process. In three directions, discover learning services included specify and discover scenario, define simulation requirements and discover services, define types and levels of game-based learning. The second direction, compose services, included design, simulation environment, compose services, and finally, execute services, included deploy and execute a composition of services, collect and analyze data, save simulation environment for reuse, provide cybersecurity support for users. A further description of the process and associated activities prescribed for users is assumed that the following supporting services and infrastructure are available: registry, repository, EDU MSaaS portal as a central front end, networking and hardware infrastructure. And in conclusion, I'd like to pay attention that such proposals can be especially useful if expanding modeling in a simulation service to augmented virtual environment, lifelong learning paradigm, as well as trends and opportunities of learning in social networks. Thank you very much for your attention, and I'd like to answer your question if you are interested in this topic, in this problem in our area of professional activity.